As Gatorland, though, the first thing they had for his park was the Florida Fish and Wildlife Institute, which was a terrible name. It was a really boring name. It sounded more like a school, not a place you bring your family and friends to go have fun. So around a year later, he came up with the name Snake Village, which was more exciting, sure, but Owen quickly found out that a lot of people are terrified of snakes. They would drive right by Snake Village without even slowing down. Of course, he couldn't have that. So in 1954, Owen's lovely wife, Pearl, was walking around their 16 acres, and she figured, well, we have all these alligators, we have all this land, why not just call it Gatorland? and the name stuck. So they had their dream of owning their own animal park. They had a great name. They just needed people to visit. Back in the time, Mickey Mouse wasn't running around Orlando quite yet. That's where they got creative. We have Warren and Sheila. Warren is the larger of the two, the male in the water. Sheila is up here in the front right corner of the bank. And even though they might look a lot like alligators, these guys are much more dangerous. They're much more agile and intelligent than their American cousins. Saltwater crocodiles are native to northern Australia. And you can just barely see Phoebe. She's the smaller female, just under the water surface, a little past Dundee from our vantage point. But Dundee, that big boy, is the largest crocodile here at Gatorland, at about 13 and a half feet long, and a little over to see how many you can spot. We've also been very fortunate. In the last 3 weeks, 15 brand new baby fawns were born right back here in the Piney Woods, so it's a very exciting time. Animal keepers. We even had an albino. She's really cool. Her name is Polaris. She'll be on display. If you're native to Australia, as you pass by, check out their feet. I know it sounds like an odd request, but birds.
Hey folks, we got a show going in just a second here. These guys are trying to get a job out here at Gator. We're going to give them a chance in just a second to show you what they can do. I'm going to run back and start up our music, and we should have a lot of fun. Just give me a little second here. We'll have it all worked out. All right, boys, do your thing. Stay there. Okay, and you too. Bubba, stay there. Don't go on out there with those gators. I know you like them, but just hold back until we get started. Anything yet, but we got the action. There's that croc, he's going in. Cracks him usually pretty good at this, and he takes it down. One on Bubba's side over there. Cooter's working on it this side. He's got a big old alligator right here, and he has a crocodile right behind him. Let's see what happens. He's working on it. Nothing going on right now. They're a little. Come on, Gator. Gator, that one's going. He's setting himself up. He's getting his. And he missed it. Okay. And right over here, we got a nice alligator. And Cooter's trying really hard. And so far, they are chasing it, but they're not making jumps. Let's see what happens. There you go. Nice jump on that side. Not high enough. So they're working on it. Come on, Gator. Make them happen. See if you get that croc over there. Bubba, look, you got a croc coming in right over there. See that croc, you get his attention, because those crocs are really good. There he is. He wants it. Can he get it? Oh, it's a really nice jump. All right. Cooter had a croc. He's right there. But that one's not doing anything. Those crocodiles, they're the best, man. Another croc over there. All the crocs are in on Bubba's side there. You got another one looking at you over there. And we got a big alligator. Looks like he might jump right there. And he's got to get it. One down over there. We got one down on each side. That's what you want to see. One down on each side. And if you just get one more on these two sides, be sure you. There you go. Crocodile, put it in. Two crocodiles coming in. One's going to get it. And he gets it. Grab that bell. And it looks like. Hey, Bo takes down. He gets 1 point for Bubba's side. That's what we wanted to see. 1 point for Bubba's side. Tell you what.
He cheated, man. That was a crocodile.
It was a crocodile. That's not a cheat, though. They come in here. What happened there?
You saw that? He swung at me like Miley Cyrus on a wrecking ball.
Okay. Oh, he's going to get that chicken out down there. He's going to put it over the side. He's got two pieces. Nice job, Cooter. He's headed to the end right now, and he's going to get it, too. They're running down. They're going to hook themselves in, and they're going to get, whoa, nice job. Looking for some high jumps here. They're working really hard at it. And Cooter's got his over the side. Bubba's got one down. Cooter's shooting for it, and we got some jumps. Make some noise for these guys, folks. That's what we like to see. One down on Bubba's side. Cooter had it. I don't know what Cooter had to see. I think he's got one down. All right, he's working on his second one, maybe? Yep, he's working. Nope, he's working on his first one, trying to make a good jump. And very nice. Good job there, Bubba. Nice job. He's got both of his down. Cooter is working on his. He's trying to get his jumps. There he goes. Nice jump. He's got one more to go. He's working on it. Mason Lodge, that boy, is trying to get a good old jump there. And you guys get to pick the winner at the end, so you better be watching, because I'm going to ask who you think the winner is. And he's working hard at it. And he's got a lot of gators there, man. A whole bunch of gators trying to get that thing out of his hands. He's taking chances, too, because you know what? It's not easy to do what Cooter's doing out there. Bring it in there, man. Cooter, go on. Get a gator to jump. Oh, he got a nice jump there. He didn't quite get it. Here we go. See if he gets it. And he gets it. So I'm going to ask you folks who you think the winner is. Who think the winner?
To the edge. ran free. The birth of a song, the death of a dream. Closer to the edge.
On the count of three, I'm gonna pull up over the wall. You ready?
Ready.
One.
I'll set the county. I'll set the county. Here we go.
One.
Come on, dude. No. Laying it on him.
Yeah, now what?
I don't know. We're gonna give him a second to catch his breath. Okay. Let's try to catch the scent with the cheese. Come on, dude. All right, we got ourselves an alligator. Totally up to him. There we go. Inside the alligator's mouth, there's 80 to 82 razor-sharp teeth. Now, these teeth are meant for ripping and tearing, not biting and chewing like ours, because they'll grab a hold of something, they'll do that death roll, and they'll swap.
Oh. Oh. You okay?
Yeah, I peed a little. Yeah, funny from out there. Everyone saw that right inside the alligator's mouth?
No, they didn't see back here.
Yes, you did.
Turn him around.
I'll turn him around. You know, people are always asking us, why don't you wrestle the big 15-footers? I'm like, why don't you shut up? That's a true story. There we go. Take two. Now, on the back of the throat, there's a pink flap of skin. That's known as the epiglottis of a palatal valve. It's a modified tongue on the alligator, so he can bite things underneath the water, and then water will rush into his lungs. That... Okay, you know what? We're done with the mouse. If you missed that, the next show is later. Someone else will show you. Okay. Moving on. We talked about how alligators have one of the strongest bites in the animal kingdom. All that power is meant for slamming it shut. It's not meant for opening. You want to go this way? We'll go this way. Okay. It's meant for close. All right, let's go. All right. Stop. Sit. Heel. All right. So, we're going to show you guys something a little different about which, that talks about the difference between alligators and crocodiles. Well,
is it open? Alright, awesome. Everybody take those pictures. Quickly. Is he smiling?
Nope.
He's smiling again. He's smiling?
Yeah.
Wait, don't let go. You're still taking pictures. This guy's changing the battery in his camera.
We're done. Huge like a thunderstorm of applause. No. When I roll him over, you're gonna sing to sleep.
No.
Yeah.
I'm not going to sing tonight.
Yeah, you are. No, you guys want to hear Andrew sing, don't you?
Seriously?
Yeah, just make sure it's something sweet. This alligator's been stubborn. How you know it's a female? I'm two ladies. I'm light enough. I'm just kidding. We all know this is a female. I couldn't keep the mouth shut this long. If you don't like that one, come in here and get me. All right, here we go. Coming up, a sleeping alligator and a singing Andrew.
Oh boy.
He rolls me over, you sing me to sleep.
Soft kitty, warm kitty, over a fur. Happy kitty, sleepy kitty,
He hates it.
What
he wants to eat the soft kitty. He wants to eat the soft kitty.
I believe I can touch the sky. I think about
nicest way I know how to wake up a sleeping alligator.
Oh.
You make a big fist, see him right between the legs, and get ready to run really, really fast.
No, it's not
the way. And you try to bite me. One, two,
no, come on.
Three!
Folks, make some noise for that alligator. He's a really good guy. Yeah. You know what? I think he injured the gator wrestler deserves a big round of applause. So give him a round of applause.
This never-ending story. Painful with pride and faith. We all fall short of glory.
Must be true love.